Hello everyone, welcome to the informative video series. So today I'm going to talk about what are the important things that you need to remember when you arrive in Netherlands for the first time. Anyone coming to Netherlands for the first time for studies, mostly I'm talking about studies, but if you come in a work visa, it also applies to you. So initially you get a MVV sticker, that is like a visa sponsor sticker, which gives you permit to stay for 60 or 90 days in Netherlands. And after you arrive here, after few months or maybe few weeks, depending on your condition, you get a residence card, which looks like a identity card, which proves that you stay in Netherlands for a valid reason. There are two important things that you need once you arrive, is a place of residence and a bank account. So what you can do is, you get a BSN number. BSN is actually similar to Aadhaar card that you have in India, or maybe a common identity number, which stays with you for the entire time, even though you leave Netherlands and come back again. It is like an identity proof and you have a unique identity number. So to apply for a BSN, you need an official contract of residence in Netherlands. So once you have the rental contract of stay in Netherlands, in anywhere in Netherlands, then you have to contact that local municipality. So for example, now I'm living in Valkenburg, so I contact Valkenburg municipality. So similarly, depending on where you live, you contact your local municipality, have an appointment, and then you get your BSN number, because you are legally staying in Netherlands. And even though you change municipalities later, your BSN number remains fixed, and that is used everywhere, right from your tax returns, bank account, everything else. So before you can open a bank account, you need a BSN number. And for the bank account, once you have the BSN number, then you can apply for bank account. And all of these appointments can be made online in their respective websites, because most of these systems here are much, much advanced. And for banks, I would say I prefer ABN AMRO and ING. These are the two topmost banks in Netherlands, but ING mostly for ABN AMRO is expat friendly, because they have most of the instructions also in English apart from Dutch. But for long term interest rates and other plus minus, I would say ING is better. But till now I have an account in ABN AMRO, because when I came to Delft, my university arranged for me that account. So normally people who don't understand Dutch, it's much easier for them to go to ABN AMRO. So it's your choice. It's up to you. And you have to browse through their website, so then you can decide which one you choose, but you should choose any one of these. Another thing you need is a DigiID. So what is a DigiID? So it's like a digital identifier. You can just log in a DigiID and create your account. It's very simple. I don't need to explain it here. Just type DigiID in Google, you will understand what it is. What it helps is, like, it links everything that you do, like your bank and your rental contract, your history of stay in Netherlands, your education. Everything is linked inside that digital repository. And once you have that DigiID, logging in that, if you activate the option that you receive digital mails instead of hard copy paper mails, then any tax office letter or any kind of letter from your municipality or any government official letter will always arrive first in your digital mailbox, and later it will come to you as a paper mail. So it's a very handy tool if you are continuously moving around Netherlands, and you should always have a DigiID. It will help you later in future when you apply for different services, and you can see all of your history of your stay in Netherlands and what you did and what you have done, everything. Let me talk about the utilities. So most of the students who come here are already given furnished houses. Even I have never explored in details about the utilities, so you don't need to. But normally the energy costs here are a bit expensive if you compare to Germany. So if you have to deal it yourself, normally your rental partner or the house you are staying, they have some contacts which internet you should choose. Normally I have heard that two best internet services here are Ziggo and T-Mobile. Currently I'm using T-Mobile. When I was in Delft, I was using Ziggo. And for energy and all, I don't have that much idea, but I have heard Eneco and others, they provide, but that's up to you to explore. So mostly students won't need that because they are given furnished houses with all the energy and everything included in the rent. And if you are eligible for any kind of discount because you don't earn a amount to sustain yourself when you are studying, or maybe your income is too low that you can get an allowance, then do please watch my videos where I have explained in details about care allowance, that is the allowance which you get in your insurance when you are working while studying, and house rent allowance which you will be eligible if you are staying in private, and there are many other conditions. I have explained it in this video. And so there is a playlist for benefits and allowances in Netherlands, and some kind of tax allowance which you will get soon once you stay in Netherlands and start working and paying taxes to the government. So you should check this to know all about the allowances that you can get while working and other things. And regarding travel, that is a very important thing. Travel is the main thing that people ask. So I have mentioned this in the cost of living video about travel. What you can do is, like, mostly people use bikes. It is very bike friendly. Amsterdam is the bike capital of the world. Once you land in Amsterdam, you'll see all orange bikes around. It's really, like, fancy. So you can purchase a bike. I don't know if I'll make a video on bikes, but maybe later. But you can browse through different Facebook groups in your locality, wherever you are going to study or stay, and you will find a lot of options. Like, a second-hand bikes will cost you. By bikes, again, I mean bicycles, because some people confuse it. It's not motorbikes. So you can buy, like, in 20 to, I don't think now it's available in 20, back in 2015, I got in 30 euros for a second-hand bike. So second-hand bike you can buy in a range of 30 to 60 euros. And if you want a new bike, it will cost you somewhere around 80, starting with, I don't think it's 80, it's something like 150 euros. And that's a non-gear bike. And most of the Netherlands is completely flat, so you won't need a gear bike. So anything within 100 to 200 euro, if you buy a new bike, is okay. But if you're a student, I recommend you to buy a second-hand bike, because that will help you to, because sometimes bikes are also stolen, so you need a good lock, and you should not pay more. So you should not be at a loss if you buy a second-hand bike and something happens with that. And moving on to, I also explain in details about the bike in the cost of living video, what are the other options of the mobile bikes, app bikes, and other things. So let me check the list if I miss anything. Okay, so apart from that, if you travel, like maybe if you're staying in Delft and going to Rotterdam, Delft, Den Haag, and other places, so for traveling, you need a OV chip card. Why do you need a OV chip card? What is the advantage? The thing is that single card can give you unfettered access to all the transport, maybe bus, tram, metro. Metros normally you find in Amsterdam or Rotterdam, not in every city. And oh, one thing I forgot to mention, if you are living in south of Netherlands, currently where I'm living, it's little bit having slopes. So there you might need a gear bike for maybe recreation or maybe while going to work. There are two types of OV chip card. One is anonymous, one is personalized. For a personalized OV chip card, first you need a bank account. And you also need a BSN number and all other things. So then only you can apply. So ideally, you can estimate like a time period of 2 to 3 months after you arrive in Netherlands to get the personalized one. So till that time, if you'll be traveling around inside Netherlands, that OV chip card is valid. And what happens is, in the personalized OV chip card, you can get certain discounts like 40%, 50%, 100%, depending on the amounts you are paying. There are different options. Just I'll leave the links in the description below. Go through that and see what are the options for the personalized OV chip card that you can apply after arriving in Netherlands. But for the anonymous one, for that short period, it's very, very wise to buy anonymous OVZip card. I will release that video probably today or tomorrow on the anonymous OVZip card, how you can buy it. It will be a very short 1 or 2 minute video. When you arrive in Schiphol, how can you buy anonymous OVZip card immediately? So it will cost you around €7.50, and if you top up some amount in that, some money in that, then that will be valid for bus, train, tram, metro, any type of public transport inside Netherlands. It works with the OVZip card. You just need to scan it and that's it. You don't need to worry about buying tickets and other things. And how does it save money for you is that if you buy tickets, like the paper tickets, for any route, whenever you are buying ticket, you are always paying €1 extra because you are printing a paper. So the government or the in Netherlands, they also want that you should use this digital version of cards or something and not waste paper. So at the end of the day, if you are traveling 10 or 20 times, you are already spending €20. So instead of that, if you buy €7.50 anonymous OVZip card, till the time you don't get the personalized OVZip card, it's much, much advantageous for you. And again, another thing is when you are buying tickets, it only works in Netherlands. So if you want to go to Belgium or Germany, which is very close by, then you need to buy tickets from the machines. And normally, if you are below 26 years old, which I am, so I'm till now getting benefits. I saw, I think, few months back when I went to Belgium, it was really, really nice because with less than 26 years, the cost to Brussels was around, both return and going and coming two ways, was around €16. And without discount, it was somewhere around €30 or €40. I don't remember. So you can imagine there's a difference of €20. So if you're under 26, you get discounts in these type of inter-country travel in Europe when you buy tickets from the machines. And regarding the anonymous OVZip card, another thing is in buses, sometimes when you buy tickets, they don't give you tickets from one point to another, point A to point B. They normally give you tickets for like the whole route. So that ticket will be valid like a day pass in trams or buses. So that again costs you €1 extra for the ticket, and that ticket may be expensive if you have to travel very short distance. So anonymous OVZip card will save you at any point of time you need to travel in short distances or anything till the time you get the personalized one. Normally, just like Germany, you don't have too much student discounts, but sometimes in Domino's and all, they have student discounts. So Domino's, you can always get a student discount by showing your student ID card. I think around €1 or €2. And in some subways, not all, people get discount of 50 cents or €1 when they show your student card. So once you become a student, you have a student ID and you can show that to get these discounts. And also in Pathé, Pathé is a local movie chain, famous theater, I would not call it theater, like a movie hall in Netherlands, and you can get a discount of €2 or €3 depending on the type of tickets you buy. So I think these are the places you get discount, not much discount in public transport, but that is what you can get as an international, because Dutch people have some different criteria. So I hope that I have touched upon different points that you need to know after you arrive in the Netherlands for the first time. And if you think that I missed something, then I will make a part 2 video. I'll be very happy to address the questions that I missed, so that before you arrive, you have a hassle-free arrival and travel. And please leave your comments below. Don't forget to leave your comments below. So based on that, I can make a second video or maybe reply you depending on the demand that I have. And don't forget to smash the thumbs up button, because that helps me to motivate me to make this kind of content for you guys, that you like the video and you are enjoying it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you have not yet. And don't forget to press the bell icon, because soon I'll be starting live streaming each week to address all the questions of the incoming students and employees or any other people. Share among all your friends. Don't forget to share. So see you in next informative series. Till then, peace.